I'm learning a little bit more about these video glasses and how they relate to YouTube. So, bear with me, folks. I'm trying to give out good and solid information that I know that worked for me. Here we are. I'm staring at one of four chrome manifold covers that I picked up on eBay. I'm going to put these on my bike, but before I do that, I'm going to explain a little bit of what I touched on. I'm going to explain a little more in detail, a little bit of what I touched on in one of my other videos about putting in atomizers. I'm trying to remember that word, sometimes it's hard. I'm getting old, folks. Atomizers in the intake route. Now, the place where I'm going to be putting them is right in there, all the way back against that shelf. There's a nice little shelf right there, and that's where the screen is going to be placed. Now, as I showed in the other video, done using an air cleaner where I cut that part out, being the screen right here. Ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. Okay, then I'm not going to tell you how I cut that screen out, but it cuts real easily with these also. So, let's move this out of the way. That is now defunct. Nope. And I wonder how my place gets to be such a mess. I am telling you what, folks, it's just the way we live. I'll clean this all off, and I'll just put it on a board and sweep it out later. Okay, I didn't clean it all off. I didn't do a real good job. I'm a man, and this is my man cave. And a man cave is a man cave. All right. Now, dug around in my stuff. I'm a reasonably resourceful man in my man cave. And I located a pill bottle top that is just the right size for same size as the intake. With that, it's just real simple, folks. We've all done this. We started doing this back in first grade, I think. And that is mark off the territory. Can you see that? I keep trying to remember to tilt my head down more, look less with my eyes when I'm recording on these things, and look more with my full head. All right. This is really all that it takes. Remember to turn that upside right. Mm-hmm. And these don't have to be really, really solid, because once they're in place, pushed back against that shelf, if I've cut them correctly, I will have just a little, I'll have to push them back in there, and in so doing, they will bend back slightly, so they'll be slightly contoured to fit and stay nice and snugly about that safe, about that shelf. There we go. And not go anywhere. Okay. I'm going to finish up the other four of these and get them prepared and ready to go onto the bike either this weekend or next weekend. This is what I did with the ones that are on the bike when I showed you the Quest for smooth running GL1000 using a single carburetor, and they were already on there. So now I've shown you how I accomplished it with some nice pretty chrome manifolds that I got off of eBay. And I'm going to finish the job now all by myself. So, for now, T-Shock out. Right. Now, another thing that I noticed about the previous video that I did talking about putting the bonnet on the Goldwing, I realized I didn't have a very good focus on the bonnets themselves. So, in order to correct this, I took them back off the bike and brought them in order to show you what they look like and how they're cut. Alright, now, this will be the left-hand side of the bike as you're facing forward. The hole right there with a little bit of green around it, that is the that is for where the little snap-in holder for the spark plug wire loom. Okay? Now, that's how it would be looking at if you were looking at it from the radiator this way. I had to come up because there's some wiring that runs through here I wanted to avoid. And then this opens up right here to allow for the throttle and the choke parts to be able to swing freely. And this again. And this also helps to vent warm air from the engine up towards the bowl on the carburetor. I'm going to add some skirts to the back here, making this just a little bit longer, increasing the efficiency ratio on it. And then this is the right-hand side as you're facing forward. All right. You see, it comes down all the way across here like this. Fits up pretty tight in there. So I had to make some, quick modifications to that. I had it a little bit too far out. And again, this clears the manifold. They set about that far apart on when it's on the machine. Okay? And then this here is cut away because the throttle cable and the fuel lines could come in contact with this. When I put the skirts on, I'll be putting the skirts on out here and out this way. And here to here, and here to here to allow the water pipe free access up underneath on the machine. So that's what they look like. Alright. Made out of thin mud flap material available at your local hardware store. Tin snip away, folks. You'd be surprised what you can get and how good it can be made to look with the tin snips in your hand. I do use a file. I do use a deburr ring tool, and I do use a rotating sanding disc mounted up in my drill press. So, those are some tools that every man should have. Every man should have them in his man cave. Thank you. For now, T-Shock out.